Since 1973, there's a look at the newly named New Era Field just outside of Buffalo, New York. Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one between the Los Angeles Rams and the Buffalo Bills. This will be taken very short. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Back to throw, gone. And incomplete to open things up.
Well, he'll definitely say that that's one he should have held on to. But when you're playing in elements like this, sometimes those bullet passes, those ones with a little bit of pace on them, they can be difficult to hold on to.
Second and 10 from the 33-yard line. Now the third leading rusher in the NFL last year, Todd Gurley. They get six here after the incompletion, and it'll leave them with a third and 4.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
From the gun on third down, gone. And that is incomplete. So the defense able to get off the field here on third down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on third down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
The four-time All-Pro Johnny Hecker is on to punt for L.A. The All-Pro Andre Roberts deep for Buffalo. On is the punter Hecker as he gets this one away. Here now Roberts. A 46-yard boot, but just 36 following a pretty decent return of 10 yards. And the Bills will take over the football with a first and 10. Allen and the Bills now with a first and 10 at their own 23. On play action, Allen. Oh, he got position on him, and he pulls it in. First play of the drive going for 14 and a first down.
The goal for any offense versus his own defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfect. And that's caught inside the 35. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. Better than a 30-yard gain as we wind down towards 30 seconds left in the quarter.
I know we love our jobs, and pretty much any play we see, we're pretty, excited about. But big plays, let's face it, that's what we absolutely live for. How about that one?
That was great. And what our camera missed was the fist pump from the sideline after that catch. They're fired out. That's a big game. Add the game here to the previous play, and it's better than 40 yards total. We're scoreless after one. Second quarter now in Buffalo. It's the Bills in control of the football as they've got it with a first and 10. Back to the ground, this time with Gore. And he'll be brought down somewhat awkwardly here, and a late flag as well. I think this one's going to be a face mask. Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post, because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
They'll try and run it with McCoy. And McCoy is in for a Bills touchdown. A 3-yard touchdown run. And the Bills are in for 6.
I know the play ends up in the end zone with one person carrying the ball, but how about that big mass of humanity that guided him to that spot?
Yeah, they got there, but I love the dive. Always a fan of the dive. Steven Hauschka for the point after. And it's 7-0 Buffalo. Just a 4-play drive that time. And it ends with a LeSean McCoy touchdown run. Hauschka now to send this one away following the score. This one taken from the 7. They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. It hasn't gone particularly well for them. That's obvious. In these conditions, no points so far. They've got to get that offense on track. The question, how do they do it?
It is the age-old question, isn't it? And to me, finding a way to make sure your playmakers touch the ball without it being too exotic. Meaning you don't have to go deep down the field. Maybe you hit them on the short passes on the perimeter. Make sure you just turn around and hand it to your best runner and get out of the way. Don't cause any extra stress on your offense.
19 yards the pick up there. Move the chains.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and brawn. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there, getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker or maybe a defensive end dropping out in a zone blitz, he's going to win that battle just about every time. But one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him, they've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep it.
Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. Now this is picked up by the Bulls. And his guys will take over at the 25-yard line. And maybe that one caused by the weather. Of course, the rain coming down. Charles, can you maybe, when you're carrying that football, grip it too tight in the rain?
I think that you can, and it's such a delicate balance, too, because when you grip it so tight, sometimes it'll slip out from your body. You squeeze it too hard, and it'll pop out on its own. I've actually had running backs talk to me about that, that when they've tried too hard, even in perfect conditions, the ball gets away from them. They've got to find a good balance, carrying it firmly, yet at the same time under control.
To throw once more on 2nd and 10. Allen, and this is caught for a Bills touchdown. 25 yards for the touchdown, and the Bills will add on to their lead. And it was a tight window. He knew he had to rocket that thing in there. He got it done.
And when you're able to complete one like that, your confidence has to just go sky high. You just mentioned it. Tight window, zings it in there despite excellent coverage. Result, touchdown.
Footing always a concern, but the extra point's up and good. And it's now 14-0. They have the short field, and they made quick work of it. Just two plays to get into the end zone. Hauschka now to send this one away following the score. This will be taken in at the 1. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. Brandon Cooks and the rest of the offensive crew trotting back into place out there. And you look at the numbers, not only has he not caught a pass, they haven't targeted him yet. And we're coming up toward halftime.
And you remember our meeting with the coach beforehand? What did he tell us about him? I write his number on my play sheet, and I circle it in bold type because I want to make sure he gets the ball and often.
Now a first down throw, gone. He'll get this complete to Cooper Kupp. Solid way to start the drive, 13 yards, picking up the first.
When you're struggling on offense, you're looking for anything possible to get you going. Sometimes you're doing like basketball teams that don't normally press. You put a press on, bring people to life, make them move a little bit quicker. Maybe that'll help them as they head towards the half.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. Charles, he doesn't seem to be particularly in tune with his receivers, just 2 for 7 throwing the football, but he did seem really locked in before the game.
Yeah, and that has to do with receivers sometimes. Sometimes the defenders knock them off their route, and they're usually pretty precise. 1, 2, 3 cut, balls out of his hands to the receiver. In this case, might be off on a half step either way. They've got to find a way to get back in sync.
He gets it to Gurley, complete. The Rams going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts, as the clock will stop with 55 seconds to go until halftime. Now Goff on first down. And incomplete, a drop there in the middle third of the field. That'll bring up 2nd down. Fair to say it hasn't been his best game throwing the football, but also not getting a lot of help out there either.
Yeah, you nailed it pretty well, you know. He's got to throw it better, got to get more help. Obviously one that should have been caught. They've got to find a way to bring those two elements together so they can make some progress in this one.
Give them 9 yards on the second down screen play.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass, looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
Now throwing on third down there, but he cannot connect. More problems here on third down. They've converted only once so far in this first half.
And you know as well as I do in this league, if you don't win on third down, it makes it hard to win a ball game because then you're relying on your defense, relying on your special teams. You've got to get it done with your offensive unit.
And this one will not get there. It's off to the left anyway. It's no good. Zuerlein, of course, last year had likely the iconic field goal of the season, booting that 57-yarder in the Superdome to send his squad to the Super Bowl.
Yeah, you really hurt the Saints fans on that one, didn't you?
Sorry.
They didn't want to hear that at all. But this guy deserves his nicknames, Greg the Leg, Legatron, because the ball goes through the post at a heavy rate, 87% in 2018.
Touchdown. Cole Beasley, 54 yards, and the Bills will extend their lead.
Heard a coach talk about those late in the half scores, especially ones that give your team a pretty decent cushion. He said those could be the ones that could finish off a squad if you let them.
Yeah, they've got the cushion. This half has been theirs. With the extra point, and that makes the score 21-0. And we can break that scoring drive down pretty easily. One play, long touchdown pass into the end zone. Hauschka now to send this one away following the score. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Jared Goff and the Rams headed back onto the field. In the second quarter, they're down big already. He's struggling as well. They've got to find something here. He's got to find something on this drive.
And sometimes you take on all that extra pressure on yourself, and maybe you have to disperse it a little bit. Lean on some other people. Lean on your teammates. Find someone who can take the pressure off and get the ball in their hands for a while.
Or this, if he doesn't, this is getting out of hand, or it could get worse. No gain there on the completion, second and 10. Well, they had the run for no gain. Now they'll try again from the 25 on second and 10. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. And now due to apparent time constraints, we fast forward to the beginning of the second half. Forecast calling for more of the same. The rain set to continue as we are underway in the second half. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. Out come the Bills now as they'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. And now you've got the clock winding down here in the third quarter. You're three scores to the good. What's your approach on this drive?
Too early to fully commit to playing the clock game. Yet at the same time, you're also not going pell-mell like you would in two-minute offense. This is what NFL offense is called, four-minute football. Take the clock out of the game a little bit, wind it down, but at the same time, keep advancing the ball down the field.
A big run there, 29 yards at a first. The safeties were well back there, and he had a lot of room. Were they in the cover too?
Yeah, they were, and the safeties were back. You know, usually they're 12 to 15 yards off the line of scrimmage, somewhere around the hash mark for each of them. But what also happens if the
LaShawn McCoy off to the races, and he'll take it into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. LaShawn McCoy, his second touchdown of the afternoon, and the Bills will add on to their lead. And he certainly played a pivotal role with those two TDs and why they're up on the scoreboard right now.
Well, someone's all about winning, aren't they? Because he's not worried about the number. Sure, it's great to have two touchdowns. But the bottom line is what he's doing is contributing to their lead. He wants to continue to do so.
The Bills make me want.
Hauschka now to send this one away following the score. This one fielded at the 5. And he will be marked down right there at the 20-yard line. Out come the Rams. They'll have it first here to begin the third quarter. And here we are almost through three quarters of play, and this passing game still has not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mildly, because they're not even over.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Teron Johnson able to pick it. And he is going to get this one back to the 20-yard line. That interception sets them up beautifully already in the red zone.
And you can hear it all the way up here. Oski, everyone turn to block, find a spot. And now they're set up inside the red zone for their offense.
Allen going to throw over the middle here to Brown. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. A 20-yard touchdown. And the Bills use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for 6. And now Sean McDermott's made the call. They'll go for 2.
All the receivers in the league are plenty good enough. Otherwise, they wouldn't make it in the NFL. But the ones that go to the Pro Bowl, they have refined route-running ability.
Oh, boy, rubbing a little salt in the wound there, going for 2 up this big.
You know, there's one time when I played, Brandon, and played against a team of just absolutely pile-driving us, and they ended up going for 2 late in the game. And I asked one of the guys, why'd you do that? He said, because we wanted to win by more. That feels like that type of situation.
Wow. Well, it could also result in a melee later, though. And the Rams getting set to go now. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. Time to establish the run game here. Gurley looking for a crease. Can't find one. Stopped at the line of scrimmage. Jerry Hughes on the stop. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle. That's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
2 runs for a net gain of nothing. Now here's 3rd and 10. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. The Rams on 3rd down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 10. From the gun, here's Gone. He's got Higbee complete right side. A loss of 1 yard, and it brings up 4th.
Well, I know it goes against the instincts of the person catching the ball because all you're ever taught is catch the football, don't drop it.
But drop it there.
Yeah, in that situation, dropping it would have been better. End up losing yardage even though they completed the pass.
As good as a sack.
Yeah, how about that? Although they won't get the same credit for it, and it won't help them at contract time.
It's a 42-yard punt. They keep him to just 1 yard on the return. And the Bills will be backed up to start the drive. They'll have it 1st and 10. In his own end zone, it's Allen. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. And it's knocked away and incomplete. The veteran Eric Weddle there to break that one up. 4th quarter, you've got the big lead. If you're coaching, Charlie, you still taking shots like that downfield?
I'd be a little more concerned with running.
A big seam, and he might go all the way. The 40, 30, 10, and finally out of bounds, just a few yards short of the goal line at the 3. A big play there on the catch and run. 97 yards, everything but pay dirt.
I don't think we'll ever get enough of watching one-handed catches, and when they pay off, they are spectacular. But how about the times they don't pay off and coaches go, two hands still works.
I know, but they go for them so often now that I'm almost starting to take them for granted.
Yeah, that's unbelievable, isn't it? Because these are sensational type plays.
Especially that one with a defender right there. Call it no gain on the keeper, and it's going to bring up a third down.
Now, that was a little too conservative for my liking. It's only second down, and they try to run the sneak. Give credit to the defense. They pushed them back and set up third down.
So off goes Allen, and on comes Steven Hauschka for the Buffalo field goal. Now the holder's going to keep it. He's going to try to run for it. The fake field goal catches everyone by surprise, and the Bills continue to pour it on.
And to me, that touchdown allows you to start grinning widely on your sideline. I think they pretty much locked this one away.
Yeah, that's the clincher, the proverbial icing on the cake, if you will. Hauschka adds the extra point, and that will extend this big lead. So the drive there took six plays, and it's culminated by a two-yard touchdown run. Hauschka now to send this one away following the score. This is taken near the 13. And a good return. He's across the 35-yard line, right around the 36. Here's the Los Angeles offense as they get set to take possession. And let's face it, this drive is not going to have any bearing on this game, but it's kind of important for one reason, isn't it?
It certainly is. You got to get points. And okay, all right, I'm being facetious here. But you get points, you feel a little bit better about yourself as you move on to the next one.
And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. An excellent way to start the drive there, 18 yards.
If he's their best threat on offense, use your number one cover guy on defense. It doesn't matter about size.
They have had him locked up. That just his first catch of the game. Big reason why they're down. Goff now just 7 of 16 passing thus far, but he's got a first and 10. A shotgun snap for Goff. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. He was in search of his tight end, Tyler Higbee, but it'll be second down. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
Well, it just seems like all game long, there hasn't been a lot of sync quarterback to wide receiver on this side of the football.
They haven't been on the same page, quarterback and receivers. Heck, they haven't been on the same grease board when you draw plays up. They haven't been on the same surface tablet that you look at on the sidelines. Nothing's worked for them. They've got to find a way to start matching each other's movements. It's not something that we see every game now. Todd Gurley held below 50 yards, and we are in the fourth quarter. Got to give a lot of credit. They've done a nice job of bottling him up.
They absolutely have. And a lot of times he can still find holes, but there haven't been the holes there. The offense looking this time for Woods, and it's intercepted. Tre'Davious White with a pick. The 20. And he is going to score. It's a pick six and a Bills touchdown. That's the story of the game. They've been suffocating all game long on defense. They were suffocating there again in a big way.
And they've done it not just by out-athleting them, which is often the case, but by being able to adjust to anything they tried to throw at them and beating them into the punch each and every time. This was a defense that was well prepared.
A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. This is taken at his 4. Well, in this one, Carter, we had some action all the way down to the final whistle there with the late points and then the kickoff to end it.
Yeah, and the